I only have my eyes closed for what feels like a moment before I hear the door to my left open. Wait, what? 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 Okay. That's happening. Pausing time. I need a moment. Jeez, I was actually had paused my timer because I wanted to, like, just keep going for a bit because I was having fun, but okay, this is going to turn into something, which means great time to pause. Okay, maybe just a few more minutes. Oh, goodness. Okay. Alrighty. Welcome back, any and everybody. This is Lynn and Otter here to do another episode of Lyre. I don't know. I gotta find a way to introduce it, but we're back. I'm excited because it's been a while. Ugh, the music is so good. I love it so much. I can't stand it. Let's see. Reduce the volume a little bit. It's a bit loud on my end, but I decided that I wanted to keep it just a little bit loud. Just in general, let me turn the fan off here. I think I'm getting a bit better at recording and audio tomfoolery because I think I'm able to get rid of some of that fan noise in the background without it sounding kind of weird. I think I'm doing okay. But I hope you guys are enjoying this so far. I'm ready to go right back into it because I had a ball with this one when we started it last time, and it seems like you guys like it too, so, like, no more fooling around. So, you watched me while I slept? Oh, so you watched me while I slept. I forgot he was not that accusatory. He was taken back by this statement.
I'm your guard. I was stationed outside of your room to keep watch. Believe me, it's not something I chose to do. It's not like you're in any danger or anything.
You mistake me. That's not what I was worried about. I'm wondering why you're up so late into the night. Do you take both day and night shift? I'd find it very hard to sleep if I did that.
I don't need that much sleep. I don't need to sleep that all that. Blah. I don't need to sleep all that much. Much.
Let me know if I should make his voice a bit deeper.
I don't need to sleep all that much. I don't need to sleep all that much.
It doesn't seem that gruff.
I don't need to sleep all that much. Much. Plus, I feel more awake at night.
Oh yeah, I've heard that some people don't need as much sleep as humans. Maybe 3 to 4 hours within a 24-hour period. I guess that's good for someone in his position. Though, if I have to have that much time during the day, I have no idea what I would do with it. If I have that much time. I know one thing I'd do. Perhaps turn my timer on. I definitely get more work done than I usually do.
Well, it's fine that you were keeping watch. Again, I was only joking.
I do enjoy watching this wolf get flustered.
You're just full of jokes, aren't you?
He shakes his head with a slight laugh, sighing as he looks at the floor. It hangs out of his mouth in a silly way. What? I take this moment of silence to ask about more important matters.
Does the king request my presence?
I realized that it was a bit foolish of me to dress for the occasion before even considering that I might not even get to meet the king today. I'm just looking forward to finally meeting him. I also want this feeling of being in the dark to go away.
I'm not even sure the king knows that you're awake at this moment, but I assume he'll find out shortly. You'll most likely be able to speak with him during supper tomorrow.
That does sound interesting. I definitely wouldn't mind having a nice meal right now. Speaking of supper,
I'm starving. Don't worry, that's already been taken care of. Leaf would have sent for one of the servers to bring you some food by now. Especially since they won't have to feed you with that weird tube. Did they seriously have to do that? I feel sick at the thought. Only twice, and don't worry, it's not that bad. That little twerp may be a bit weird at times, but he knows his way around medicine and has been able to achieve great things. Achieve things most wouldn't even imagine to be possible. Lyle has an odd relationship with the bird. It sounds like he respects him, though. From what I've seen, he seems to know his way around his work, and I trust him. He seems pretty jumpy, though. I wouldn't imagine he's the best at surgery. Unless he had help. Then again, I'm still here. So, how did you find yourself in this position, in your position? Well, that came out of nowhere. I think for a moment about what I should say. I don't want to give away too much about myself. But the more I think about it, I realize there isn't much to give away. Well, I was granted nobility in the West, and I'm good at what I do. At least, I like to think that I am. Sometimes I feel like the others have done all the work for me. Or the work I did was for others and not for myself. Something like that. The look on Lyle's face tells me that was a bit too vague. What? That's it? He has an unsatisfied look on his face. But then he shrugs. I'm sure there's more to it. I'll find out in due time. Well, if I'm going to tell you my life story, you'd better tell me yours. And I'll need a drink. Deal. Wine's over there. Here. It's not even the 18th hour by the time the sun disappears behind the mountains, and I'm forced to light a few candles. I've taken off my coat, folded it, and set it down in the corner for tomorrow. Lyle is reclined in one of the chairs, his paws kicked up as he tells me about when he was a squire. Of course, most of the time I just felt like an assistant. His ears twist in the direction of the door. It wasn't always combat training. And suddenly, there's a knock at the door. His ears perk up and he sniffs at the air. Did I hear that sniffing sound? Okay, I guess not. I thought I smelled food. Really? Because all I can smell is wine. Oh, you guys are a little tipsy, maybe? He stumbles getting up. Oh, are you guys a little drunk? He stumbles up getting up, yet confidently walks over to the door. Though he tries to hide it, he's a bit tipsy. Sorry, alarm for something else. Wow, I'd be surprised if he didn't trip over his cape. Then again, I don't have much of a clear head either. He swings open the door and greets the server. Hello. Please, come in. Lyle steps back and a servant enters, pushing a cart through. They walk under Lyle's arms like an archway as he holds the door open for them. The cart is filled to the brim with all different types of foods. Some hot, some cold. Roasted duck, cooked fish, all laid on greens surrounded by vegetables. Steam rises off them like they were just pulled from the fire. There's some bread and cheese, with a weird sauce off to the side. On a side tray, there's a fresh bottle of wine with what looks to be a piece of mint. Thank you. I call out to the server standing in the doorway. He nods in acknowledgement and leaves. Lyle stands there for a moment before adjusting his cape. Well, I hope you enjoy your meal. He makes to leave the room, but before he can, I speak up. Oh, you're not going to join me? He pauses for a moment and turns to answer. That's very generous of you, but I'll just go eat in my quarters later. Besides, I've already raided you of your wine. And I have certain things I need to do.
I'm sad to see him go, but then again, he also looks a bit conflicted. I don't think I can be alone right now.
I need some company after everything that's happened. Oh, come on. I insist. Besides, this is way too much food, even for someone who hasn't had a proper meal in days. Clearly, whoever sent this knew more than one person would partake. He turns away from the door before closing it with a smile on his face. As my lord commands. He walks back over to one of the chairs and sits down. Nice. I take a nice portion of duck and place it on the side of my plate. The fish looks really good, so I grab some of that as well. Just as I'm about to head back to my seat, there's a piece of parchment folded up and placed in the center of the tray. I pick up the note and read it. Enjoy. R. Zar. I pocket the note, and once I'm done, Lyle begins filling up his plate. He takes quite a bit of the duck, and most of it is gone by the time he's done plating his food. And I thought I was taking a lot. He is bigger than me, so it makes sense that he would need more. A glass of wine was enough for me, but for him, he needed a whole bottle. Gripping it in his paw, it was like a medicine bottle with how small it looked. He plops into his chair and starts to eat, cutting into the duck with a fork and knife. As he drags the knife through the meat, he continues his story. Anyway, I squired for Lord Brian up until the age of 19. Then I was made an anointed knight by the king.
I've heard most are knighted until they're at least 21. And now you're the captain?
Yes.
How old are you now?
22.
Oh wow, he's young.
You're captain of the guard and you're only 22? I blurt this out, but end up regretting it when I see his bashful expression. I didn't mean to seem so surprised. I'm only just about to turn 20, and I'm already being sent far away on diplomatic missions, so I guess I have no leg to stand on. But still, to be knighted at such a young age. Believe me, I was just as surprised as you are. But as a captain, usually has a next in line selected in case they die. When Sir Runar died, it was revealed that he had me chosen as his successor. Everyone said that he was grooming me for command, but I didn't really expect to get there so soon. The king was pleased with this, though, so I didn't question it.
He takes a grape, pops it in his mouth, and chews it with a distant look on his face.
Did you not want to be captain?
He stops chewing for a moment, trying to process the question.
It's something that I absolutely wanted, but it just happened so fast.
Yeah, I understand. It must be stressful being put into a position like that so fast. Well, I'm sure you're doing a good job at it.
I hope so.
He takes another drink from his cup, making a loud slurping noise. I take a bite from my fish. It's the best food I've had in a long time. The fish tastes considerably different from the fish off the coast of Erin, but it's still so good. Maybe it's because I was so hungry. Or maybe it's the company. Lyle empties his cup and then reaches for the pitcher to pour some more.
So, Richter, how old are you?
I'm 19.
You look a bit older than 19 to me.
I cock an eyebrow at him.
Not that that's a bad thing.
Well, the same can be said for you, Scruffy.
Ooh, I drag my finger across my right eye, hinting at a scar.
I guess so.
Actually, since he's younger, maybe I should make his voice a bit lighter. Well, no, your voice goes deeper by 22, by 20. He reaches up and grabs a paw over his eye, while chuckling.
Though, I prefer rugged over scruffy.
How did you get it? If you don't mind me asking.
He contemplates for a moment, then pours more wine.
I'll tell you that story someday. And I'd need a lot more wine than this.
He lifts the bottle and sloshes it around slightly. His speech is a bit slurred due to the drunk state he's in. He takes a big drink from his cup and lowers it with a satisfied exhale.
It must be an interesting story.
That's one way to describe it.
It doesn't look recent. Did you get it during training?
Again. I'm sorry, but I'd really rather not talk about it right now.
I hold up my hands. I'm sorry, I really didn't mean to pry. Sometimes my curiosity gets the better of me and I ask too many questions.
I understand. I can do the same thing sometimes, so don't worry.
He picks up his empty plate and sets it on the tray. I really hope I didn't make him too uncomfortable with that. I'm finishing a piece of bread when I notice his eyes light up.
Can I, have this piece of mint?
He holds up the little bundle of leaves, just barely pinching it between the claws on his gloves.
Sure, you can have it.
Thank you.
He pops a piece of it in his mouth and chews on it. I finish my plate and place it on the tray as well. I'm feeling really tired now that I've had some food in my stomach. Lyle senses this and motions towards the door.
Thanks for letting me eat with you, but...
He gets up from his chair with a grunt and pats the lower part of his breastplate.
I should probably be going. And I'm sure that you're going to have a busy day tomorrow.
He starts walking towards the door. No need to thank me. You're good company. He smiles and opens the door.
Have a good night. And I'll be guarding the hall for a bit if you need anything.
Good night. Thank you.
You're welcome.
He stumbles through the door and it closes with a thud. I take off my clothes, blow out the candles, and then fall into bed. I've only been awake for a couple hours, but I feel so tired. My side still feels a bit sore, but it should get better with time. I try to sleep on my stomach, but it causes my side to hurt even more, so I lay down on my back instead. Lyle and Leaf seem very kind. Especially Lyle. I'm glad that I was in their care while I was out. The wine gets to me and I slowly drift off into a deep sleep.
Oh, okay.
Oops. My eyes feel dry and burn at the corners. I lay there motionless, not because I can't move, but because I don't want to. I feel so exhausted. The lower halves of my arms and legs feel like stone pillars. Jeez, hungover. I slowly try to collect myself as I wake up. Sometimes when I'm waking up, it takes me a minute to realize that I'm even awake. I have to steadily become more aware of my surroundings and try to grasp what's going on. I groggily open my eyes. It's still night? I look out the moonlit window and scan the room, adjusting my eyes. That would make sense considering how much sleep I've already gotten. I raise myself from my reclined position. Halfway up, I feel a tug at my throat. It feels like a smooth rope is wrapped around my neck. Suddenly, I'm pulled back by a hard jolt. Then I feel a burning substance lurch down my throat. It's acidic and has a terrible taste to it. What's happening? I struggle underneath the grasp of the rope, but it appears pointless. There's a harder tug as it pulls me deeper into the bed. I feel the burning liquid pouring down my throat faster now as my upper body sinks into the covers. I try to scream out for Lyle, hoping that he's still in the hall. In the hall still, shadows are cast through the crack under the door. It looks like someone is on the other side, standing in front of it. Finally, as my vision begins to fade along with my hearing, there's a muffled breath in my right ear. What the heck? I jolt awake, eyes wide open, breathing hard as my chest heaves up and down. The early morning light is pouring through the window, casting a pink hue on the bricks. Oh, I hate nightmares. I don't know if that was a nightmare. Especially the realistic ones. They're even scarier when they make sense. That's much different when they consist of preposterous scenarios that could never even happen. Nightmares like the one I just had are the ones that linger in my head for a while afterwards. I've really got to stop drinking before bed. I mutter this to myself. Rubbing the sides of my head. I rustle out of bed and get to my feet. The ground is still a bit cold. I should probably ask if I could have a rug brought up. I walk across the room, my bare feet lightly patting against the cool ground, sending a fresh feeling throughout my body. The stress from that vivid nightmare is slowly fading away as I lightly move towards the window. Once I reach it, I press my hand to the cold glass and look outside. There isn't much to see from the side of the castle, just some mountains in the sky. I wish I had a view of the town. I stare out at the mountains and the way they cascade down from the skies like great stone blankets over the covered in grass. The trees are slowly losing their leaves as winter approaches. I hear the door open and some shuffling. When I turn around, I see Leaf standing in the doorway, carrying a tray with food. I see some meat, cheese, bread, and a cream spread. It all looks really good, and I am a bit hungry.
Good morning, Lord Richter.
Richter, I hope that you slept well. Good morning, Leaf. And no, not as well as one would hope. I'm sorry to hear that. Either way, you slept more than enough. Some time being awake would do you some good. He lifts the tray in his hands, adjusting his grip on it. I thought that I would bring your breakfast up, since I also wanted to give you some of this. He nudges the corner of the tray where a small bottle shakes around. You seem to be doing fine right now, but just in case you feel any pain, you can take a spoonful of this. I rub my side and don't really feel any discomfort. It does feel a bit sore, though. Thank you.
It's no problem. It's no problem, really.
He sets the tray down on the small table next to my bed. After fiddling with one of the bottles, he turns and looks in my direction. His gaze meets with my side and he tilts his head in curiosity.
You're healing very fast.
I rub at my side and shrug.
Humans do that.
You said it yourself. I did. I have the fortunate opportunity of knowing another human, but she's never been injured this badly. It's very interesting seeing your body recover so fast.
I decide to change the subject as I'm afraid he might politely ask to vivisect me.
How often do you wear that?
I say, limply raising my hand and pointing to his mask.
I find that it's very useful in my profession. I've never gotten sick after helping a patient.
He holds his hands together down by his waist as he idly pats his clawed foot against the ground.
Has anyone ever seen your face?
He looks down with a sigh of defeat and then wrings his gloved hands up behind his head.
Of course people have seen my face.
I see him start to fiddle with a little leather latch on the back.
Still, I had to wear this once for a procedure, and ever since, I find a certain comfort in wearing it.
He pulls the mask off, tossing it onto the bed.
Oh, he's kinda cute.
He takes his hat off and looks up at me.
Aww.
He looks like a raven, which I find ironic. However, he's about the size of a crow. His little beady green eyes stare up at me with a look of expectancy. Without the mask, he looks a lot more approachable. I know he's a lot older than me, but he's almost cute.
I don't know how offensive that is, so I'll refrain from saying anything.
Satisfied?
He says in a curious yet slightly annoyed tone.
Sorry.
Yes, perfectly satisfied. I say this back to him with some satisfaction in my tone. He goes to put his mask back on while averting his gaze.
I feel a lot better with you poking and prodding me now that I know what you look like.
Thank you.
Well, I'm glad I can make you feel a bit more comfortable.
He steps over to the door and opens it.
If you have any questions, just ask me or anyone around the castle.
Where's Lyle?
With it being the first thought that comes to mind, I blurt it out without any hesitation. Leaf pauses for a moment, leaning his head out of the doorway to quickly stare down the hall.
At this time of morning? He could be anywhere.
I wonder if he's sleeping. One would hope he didn't stay out in the halls all night. I try to think of another question I might have. I could really use a bath. I feel very unclean.
Where is the bathing room?
If you had left, it's at the very end of the hallway behind the wooden door painted white.
Left, wooden door, painted white. Got it.
Thank you. You're very welcome. Have a nice day.
With that, he leaves through the doorway and I'm left alone again. I'm glad that I managed to get him to take off that mask. It's not like I'm someone riddled with a contagious disease.
Still, if he finds comfort in it, then it's not my place to judge.
I walk over to the desk near the door and fidget with some of the things on it. There's a nice-looking quill which I pick up and twirl around in my fingers. I set it back down and then walk over to my pile of belongings. I'll probably have someone come up and unpack my things later. I guess I can arrange them to my liking once they're at least out of their trunks. Especially the clothes. I turn back to the tray of food sitting on my bed and carry it over to the desk. Sitting down in the chair, I scoot it forward. It's very comfortable, and the desk is also at the perfect height. I go through the food pretty quickly as I stare out the window at the clouds moving by. Before I know it, I'm done with my meal and drink the last drop of water. It only takes me a couple of minutes to gather myself and head out the door. Stepping out into the hallway, the walls are lined with stone pillars, and there's an occasional portrait, statue, or torch. As I near the end of the hall, it turns into a sort of balcony. The pillars are separated by arched windows. I get a nice view of the fort from here. Fjord? The light from outside pours into the hall and lights up the bricks with a pink glow. A large door stands at the end of the hallway, the light shining off of it, making it contrast against the walls. I approach it and grab onto the handle. And there's some resistance as I pull on the door, and I'm forced to put my back into it. I pull harder and it finally budges. I swing the door open, and I'm met with a wonderful smell. Ooh. My eyes are instantly drawn to a large empty pool in the center of the room, with a towering fountain in the center. The faucet is shaped like a weird spiraled antler and made of gold metal. I step into the room, the noise echoing off the walls. Even with the sound of my shoes hitting the ground, the room is peacefully quiet. To my right are three tall windows. Their glass is stained blue, green, and yellow. The green one is in the middle and slightly taller than the other two. Figures. I whisper this to myself under my breath. It reverberates around the room regardless. On my left, there's another large door, presumably leading to a place to change. There are some carved benches against the walls and some towels which have been folded and stacked next to a laundry chute. I set the clothes that I plan on changing into next to the towels, making sure the surface is dry. I turn and look at the pool, circling the edge, examining the fountain and trying to figure it out. After another quick scan of the room, I see some levers up against the wall in the corner. Walking up to them, I see that they have different colored handles, and I figure this is the contraption to get the water flowing. One of the handles says water, another says mineral water, one says salt. Each handle has a different type of bath water and have some soaps labeled on them. I don't really know which to choose, so I decide to have some fun and just pull all the levers by just a bit. There's a rumbling in the walls that travels through the floors and pipes snaking around under my feet. Oh, I'm glad they have running water. I could exist in this time period if we have that. Water starts to funnel out of the prongs in the antler, arching through the air and pooling into the bowl in the center. That's cool. The water is all different colors, probably due to being mixed with so many kinds of soaps and other bath products. It fills up the bowl in the center quickly, and soon a pillar of water starts to flow over the edge of the rim, splashing at the bottom of the pool. After a while, the water is filled up to an adequate height and starts to drain out to the side so that it doesn't overflow. It's a very enchanting sight, watching the light from the colored windows shine into the pale room and bounce off the multicolored pool. Yeah, sounds nice. The beams of light bounce off the wall and up to the ceiling. I look up and see a large owl statue shelved into the wall above the door where I entered, its wings spread out in a large fan. I walk over to the bench next to the laundry chute and start to strip off my clothes. Once my dirty clothes are removed, I lay them in a pile on the bench and walk over to the large tub, my bare feet cold on the floor. The thick floral scent that I was hit with when I first entered the bathroom has gotten stronger now that the tub is being churned with different oils and soaps. Large bubbles are forming on the surface, and they're all beautiful colors. I sit near the edge and slowly lower my foot past the bubbles and into the water. At first, the water feels cold, but as my nerves register the feeling, there's a warm sensation around my foot. I ease myself into the water, and the warmth surrounds my body as I lean against the wall of the pool with my back to the entrance. The water is thick with fragrance and feels amazing on my skin. Oh, I dunk my head under the water, closing my eyes as I quickly wet my hair. When I bring my head back out of the water, I feel refreshed and rejuvenated. Although Lyle said that I didn't smell, there was no denying that I felt very dirty. I carefully start to scrub my arms and legs, cleaning myself as best I can. The waters wash away my worries, and my mind drifts away from all the strange things that have happened so far, along with the weird dream I had this morning. I finish cleaning everything and lean back against the wall of the pool, closing my eyes to rest for a moment. As I sit there, I can feel the warm water soak into my skin, losing myself to the feeling of comfort. Ah.
I wonder.
I only have my eyes closed for what feels like a moment before I hear the door to my left open. Wait, what? 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 Okay. That's happening. Oh, God. Lyle steps into the room, sliding through the half-open doorway. He stops in his tracks when he sees me, and time seems to freeze. Wait, was there a sound effect? Oh, no, that was just the words.
I.
He shakes his head as if trying to clear his mind, and then takes a few steps forward, averting my gaze. Pausing time. I need a moment. Jeez, I actually had paused my timer because I wanted to, like, just keep going for a bit because I was having fun, but okay, this is going to turn into something, which means great time to pause. Okay, maybe just a few more minutes. Oh, goodness.
I didn't think anyone else would be in here.
I can no longer relish in the warmth of the water as I sit there, frozen with shock. My spine feels like it's made of ice, and any sudden movement might break it. I just stare at him with wide eyes. He stops in place, waiting for my response, but then continues to shuffle towards the bath. Walking to the edge of the pool that's across from me, he slowly starts to get in. I look like a fool sitting in the water with a dumbstruck look on my face. I try to keep my eyes on his, but they fall to the one place I knew they would. Where, Richter? Where? I can't help but glance at his bits as they rest between his legs in full view. They're quite large, and I quickly gather my thoughts and try to come up with something to say. Something to fill the silence threatening to kill me. I really needed a bath. I bring my arms in and slink into the water. Oh, thank goodness he hit it. Jeez-um. Lyle steps into the water and leans back against the wall with his arms crossed over his chest. There's a small wave created from him getting into the water, which rolls over to my end of the pool. His bushy tail floats on the surface behind him before getting too wet and slowly sinking under the water.
I would feel the same if I'd been through what you've been through.
Yes. The awkward silence fills the room once more as we both sit there. The red slowly fades from my face over time as I grow more and more comfortable with the situation. How was your morning? I kind of want to keep going, but I'll pause it here. Alrighty. Yeah, that's me. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you liked it. I couldn't help... This is good. I didn't realize we'd get into some steamy bits so soon. I'm thinking these episodes will probably be a bit longer than like the 90 minutes that I usually go for. So, you know, that'll be something hopefully to look forward to if you guys don't mind. Maybe you prefer the shorter form. But I'm noticing that sometimes, you know, the story can kind of move a bit slow, which is fine. You know, I'm reading this. But, you know, in an episode, I could be staring at the same background for the entire 19 minutes. And I feel like if I can get forward and have it change, you know, might be a bit more interesting for you. So just trying to, you know, get through it. But I hope you guys liked it. I'm intrigued. I've been told that the story gets pretty dark and intense. So, I mean, there's clearly going to be a romance, but I'm curious as to the other parts of and other tones the story's going to take too. But, I got frazzled. Jeez, first, one last night, now this. Okay. What was I saying? I hope you guys liked it. I appreciate any and all comments that you guys leave on my videos, suggestions for other games or otherwise, just, you know, any comments, they're fine. I really enjoy reading them and they really, you know, if any suggestions, even critiques, you know, if I haven't said that before, I mean, if you think I should do different voices or you think my voices are, you know, maybe could lessen them here or something about the editing, let me know. I'm really trying to reach 1,000 subscribers and, you know, obviously the best way I can do that and what would make me feel great is to know that I got there doing things that people really enjoyed. So, regardless, thanks again for tuning in, and we'll just see you guys on the next one. Bye for now. Take care.